Hello guys, so welcome to KO Tutorials. So let's continue with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as you can see over here, we have started with the lighting part of this particular interior over here. So as you can see over here, I have added a V-Ray sun and two V-Ray lights over here. So this would be your source light, that's your key light. This will be your fill, and we have kept this two as supporting lights over here. So now what I'll be doing over here is like, let's see the render over here first, how it looks like. So let's go into rendering and let's just render it. So as you can see, the light is very high. Still we can reduce the lights over here. So we can reduce the intensity of the lights. So let's go into this, into the sun, V-Ray sun. And you have an intensity multiplier, I'll keep it as 0.08 for now over here. After that, okay. So few changes, let's go into the rendering. If you're going to go with some night lights, if you don't want a sunlight, then we can also use some interior lights like photometric lights also. So let's go into rendering. Render setup over here, and we'll do some render settings over here. So let's go into the V-Ray. So let's go into the global switches, go down, we'll keep this your anti-aliasing, we'll keep it as adaptive subdivision over here. So you can see the difference that creates the virtual subpixels for, you know. After that, filter, we can keep it as Michel over here. We'll keep it as Michel. So trade off blurring against ringing and anisotropy. That's, you can also keep it as Catmull room. That's a 25 pixel filter with enhanced edge defects. So we'll keep this as Michel over here for now. I'll increase this minimum rate to 2 and maximum by 4 over here. I'll go into global DMC. And definitely we are going to work with the noise part. So I'll just keep it as 0.001 for now. Go into the environment. We can keep it as GI environment for now. So we can definitely add a HDRI map also if it is required. Go into color mapping. We'll keep it as your exponential over here. Let's go into GI and let's just enable this. Primary is, as usually we keep it as iridescence map. The secondary will be light cache over here. Go into iridescence map and set the, you know, current preset as medium over here. And we'll go into the subdivisions. Increase the subdivisions by 160 and 60 over here. Light cache, I'll keep it for now as 1200. So let's again go back to the camera. Before that, I'll add a, you know, HDRI map. How I can add a HDRI map? Let's go into material over here. I'll go over here, get material. I'll call a material over here. I'll go down and I'll call a V-Ray HDRI. So let's load the bitmap file over here. Let's just load the bitmap file. So this is for the night. Let's go onto the desktop for HDRI. Okay, this is a HDRI file which I selected over here. I'll set this to spherical over here for now. I'll select this light, select this V-Ray light, and into that I'll go into the options I'll go down, and you have a texture option over here. I'll just drag this over here. I'll make it as instance over here. I'll increase the resolution to 048. Go into rendering, go into the environment, and instead of this V-Ray sky, I'll just add a HDRI map over here. So go into rendering, go into render setup, go into V-Ray, and into that, go into the GI environment and also add this HDRI map. Let's go back to the camera view and let's render and see how it looks like. So we can, as you can see, we can slightly increase the intensity of sunlight. That can be done. Can slightly increase the intensity of sunlight over here. So let's just select this and I'll make it to 0.2 over here. And let's render and see again. So let it render. So as you can see over here, so rendering is in process. So what other things we can take care over here is like, we can check out the reflections. Also, if the noise is more, we can slightly reduce the noise also. We'll be going through that. So let's again go into the material over here. I'll go into the slate material editor. And if you really don't require noise, we can remove the noise. So that would be much better. So I'll just remove this noise over here from this. Also, I'll be removing this noise from this part. So we have removed the noise from the flooring in this bed texture. Now, I'll go over here, I'll slightly shuffle this vertices till here, and I'll again take one more V-Ray light. Let's take one more V-Ray light and I'll place this V-Ray light right exactly near the window. I'll just mirror it in x-axis. I'll just push this over here. I'll again go over here into the temperature. That's totally fine, but we'll reduce the temperature of it. Multiplier, I'm sorry. So reduce the multiplier to 0.2 over here for now. So rest of the settings, like we'll off the cast shadow over here. So I don't need a cast shadow for now. Again, let's go into the material. And same way, we'll just duplicate this and put it in the texture panel over here. Let's just render it and see how it looks like. Okay. Looks much better. So what I have done over here is like, I have removed the, you know, the vertices over here from this side. I have adjusted it. And we have used the HDRI map in the environment. Let's see the render. So definitely it's going to take time. So let it render. Okay. So I'll put the render output of this in the thumbnail window. And in the coming session, what we'll be doing is like we'll be adding some light passes over here. So I'll put the output in the thumbnail of the video. So we'll be doing some more adjustments to the light also. So guys, if any doubts, please put it in the comment section over here. So let it render, I'll just put the output. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the coming tutorial. So thanks for watching this tutorial.